nice thing to think about before you turn in tonight? Bed bugs.
Now, make no mistake, bed bugs are real and becoming a serious threat across the U.S. In the past week, there have been emergency health meetings in Kentucky, New York, Ohio, and Indiana over growing infestation problems. Changes in pesticide regulations and more world travel have bed bugs thriving. One Lincoln woman has firsthand knowledge. KATV NewsWatch 7's Julie Cornell joins us with more.
Bed bugs are real. They're not just born out of fairy tales and clever sayings. Tonight, we go inside an infestation and check out the big hassle of these little bugs. This is an apartment that welcomes pets with a bird, iguana, fish, dog, and guinea pigs. But there are some unwelcome critters that keep Angie Rempe awake at night.
And I look at the ceiling everywhere I go.
Angie, her husband, and four kids have company.
Where do I find the bugs? All over.
Bed bugs live here.
I've got them in the baseboards, I've got them on the ceilings, in the closets. You'll see all the little white spots, and those are all the eggs.
Eggs the size of a pinhead, and quarter-inch bugs that come out at night to bite.
Oh, now he's moving. You see him moving?
We invited UNL Extension educator Barb Ogg to Angie's apartment. She's a bed bug expert.
They only feed by sucking blood. So they're parasites.
Ogg says killing bed bugs requires expensive, invasive treatments every few weeks till they're gone.
Ew. Okay.
Yeah, that's definitely a bed bug.
Holes must be drilled to place the pesticide, and they need to be patched immediately.
If you leave cracks or little holes, then they serve as houses for them.
Angie's family sleeps on the floor because their beds were infested.
By the time we had found out what they were, they had already coated the seams of the mattresses.
Og tells the family anything that's soft needs to be laundered and sealed in a bag or thrown away.
He jumps on me on the screen. I've seen him on the kids before. My sister stayed over one night and had one crawl in her ear.
Harvard University has done extensive research on the bugs. One problem? These guys can hide out for up to a year without feeding. They're survivors, which means that you can carry them with you when you move. Rempe's basically living out of her garage.
What we can salvage, we put in here. The rest of it we've thrown away.
Experts say the bites are like mosquito bites, but the psychological impact is lasting. Just knowing they're looking for their next meal while you sleep.
You don't want to go to sleep, you're afraid, you know, there's insomnia, there's certainly stress.
Stress that continues until the bed bugs go away.
Sleep tight, don't let the bed bugs bite. Yeah, I don't say that no more.
The property manager of Angie's Apartments is working closely with UNL experts and a pest control company to kill the bed bugs. Bed bugs don't spread disease. No one is certain how they spread to Angie's apartment. With more complete coverage, Julie Cornell, KETV NewsWatch 7.